Hi there, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you are not new here. My name is Emily, and I do a bunch of tutorials on Salesforce and related systems. So today we're going to be going over how to create a tabular report in Salesforce. I am currently doing a series on reporting. So if you want to join for that, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Let's go ahead and jump into reports, but first, make sure that you are in the correct app. I am currently in the sales app, and so I have access to the reports tab over here. If you are not in the sales app and you don't see reports, then go ahead and go into the app launcher. You can search for apps or click view all, and you should be able to jump into an app that has reporting available. Or you can just search for reporting here and you can go into there. But I like to do the tab. So from here, let's go ahead and go into new report. This is going to get us to choose the report type. I do have a video coming out as a part of the series on report types. If that is out, I'll try and link that down below, but the playlist will be linked down below. So let's go ahead and jump into just a regular opportunity report type and click continue. One thing that I really like to have toggled on is this update preview automatically. This will help us not have to click save and run every time and then jump back into the editor. Super duper helpful. A few things before we jump into the report format is that we want to open up our filters so then we know what kind of data we are working with. Filters help you narrow down the set of information that you're going to see. So I'm going to change the close date range, and that should help us see more information. Click apply and it'll update. There we go. I'm also going to get rid of some blank information that we have. There are a few ways to do this. You can do this at the outline and then click the X, or you can click this little caret and then say remove column. There you go. Now we have that gone. Next step is empty. So I'm going to remove that. Sorry if I'm scrolling too fast, but all the other information seems to be at least partially filled out for some of these accounts. So I'm going to leave all of that. And here you have a tabular report. So there are four report formats. Not to be confused with report types, but these are report formats. A tabular report is just a table of information. Typically, you may not have it narrowed down very much. You can narrow it down. So we could narrow it down by the fiscal period. And it's going to equal, let's say, Q3 of 2007, because I can see that over here. Click apply, and then it narrows it down a little bit more. The thing that would disqualify this from being a tabular report is if we were to create a group. If we were to group it by amount, or if we were to group it by another thing of information, or if we were to summarize this by possibly expected revenue or amount. So yeah, there you have it, a tabular report. If this was helpful, be sure to give this video a like. If you have any questions, drop them down below. If there are any other tutorials that you would like, comment down below and I will add it to my list. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.